guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Thank you for being here today. As always, if you are new here and you are interested in tarot cards, tarot readings, true crime cases, missing persons cases, and the occasional candle making video, please consider subscribing. I so appreciate it. And a big thank you to those of you who come back every week and support me on the true crime videos as well as the candle making videos. I thank you oh so much. That really means a lot to me. And I also want to thank all of you who have reached out for a private tarot reading this week. There's been several of you, actually, and it's really kept me busy, so I really appreciate that. I will have that information in the description box. All you have to do is email me. Just put tarot reading or private tarot reading in the subject line, and I will get back to you. Usually turnaround time is within that day. Depending on the situation, there was a couple of readings where I was literally just sitting here at home, and you know, they came in and I was able to turn around and get them done right then and there. So what I'll do is I'll just record it just like how I do here. It's the same format. I use several different decks, well, two or three different decks, plus an oracle card at the end for a final message, and then I upload it to YouTube, but I upload it as an unlisted video, which just means that the only person able to view it is you, or the person that I send the link to, which is you. So I keep the video up there as long as you want it up there. You can go back and view it as many times as you want, and so that's how that works. So if you're interested, I thank you. Just reach out to me and I'll get right back to you. All right, so for today's reading, this was a requested video, and it was requested quite a while ago. I went back to my original card, and I tried to find all the cases that were really like the first handful of cases that were requested. And so Bradley Wayne Allen was on that list. And I had a hard time finding information about this case. I did come across a video, and it's literally like the only video that's on this case. And it was an interview with Bradley's mom. And so I am going to share that in the description box as well. It's like my only source plus the Charlie Project. There's really nothing out there about him. It is a very fresh case. It just happened in 2017. But this is really a sad case, and I think it's time that I covered it, and we'll see what kind of information we can come up with. But Bradley seemed like, you know, just a great guy, outgoing, loved to be outdoors, hunter, fisher. He worked in construction. I think he had experience in welding. He had a girlfriend. They have a son together. I believe that the son is now 4 years old. The girlfriend's name was Megan. And what it sounds like is his parents had about 20 acres of land or property. And I believe that Bradley and his girlfriend Megan and their son were living in a trailer on that property. Now, I don't know the proximity of his trailer and his parents' house, or, you know, if this was in, you know, was it, you know, 22 acres is quite large, so they could have had some distance between the two of them. I don't necessarily know if the parents would see him coming and going every day. I don't know if they were that close. So on the day of his disappearance, apparently his girlfriend Megan is saying that they got into an argument around 3 o'clock in the morning, and he stormed off to cool off and take a walk in the woods, and that's it. She's never heard from him since. However, Megan failed to report him missing to his parents or to anyone for 3 days. So when the police were involved in this, 3 days had already gone by. 3 days that are very important, as we know in these cases. You really want to get a fresh start or a quick start on these cases. And right off the bat, they were behind 3 days. So I am going to read just the basic detail of the disappearance from the Charlie Project, and then we'll get into the reading. So we have missing since July 18th, 2017 from Fountain Hill, Arkansas. Allen was last seen at his family's 20-acre property off Ashley Road 80 in Fountain Hill, Arkansas on July 18, 2017. His girlfriend stated that they got into an argument, and at 3 a.m. he told her he was going for a walk into the woods to cool off. He said he'd return in a few hours. His girlfriend went to sleep, and when she woke up, he still hadn't returned home. His family reported him missing a few days later. Alan left behind his wallet and debit card. His paycheck was automatically deposited into his bank account, but there was no activity on the account after his disappearance and no activity on his phone either. His phone either is switched off or the battery has died. Foul play is suspected in Alan's disappearance, which remains unsolved. So I don't really care for how they word his family reported him missing a few days later. Because from what it sounds like, his family didn't even know he was missing. His girlfriend Megan was the one who knew he was missing, and she failed to report anything to anyone. So that's why, you know, it took 3 days for the police to get involved. And as far as his phone is concerned, I believe that there's some discrepancies as far as Megan's story about that. There's a story where she says that he took his phone with him. There's a story that she says he didn't take his phone, so it's hard to tell. But when I listened to the interview with his mom said something about him having a prepaid phone. And I guess with prepaid phones, it's harder to get the information from them, but the police did finally get the information from this prepaid phone. And they did find out that his last phone call on this prepaid phone was that evening or the night before he went missing to another man, a local man in that area. Now, I don't I have to go into the other area of this case is that there are drugs involved. So, it sounded like Bradley, as well as his girlfriend Megan, had been addicted to, I believe his choice of drug was meth. So they had been dealing with their addictions with that. Bradley had been in and out of rehab centers to no luck. You know, he has struggled with the law. He has been dealing with this for quite some time. I believe that this person that they found he had spoken to, or at least there was some communication with, or a call or something made from this prepaid phone call, the man that he had spoken to or talked to or reached out to is also in the drug area, okay? So something to do with drugs. Now, I think that the police did go to this man's, and I don't know this man's name, okay? The police did go to this man's trailer. I believe this man's trailer is probably within a 5 mile distance from where Bradley and Megan were living, on this large property of his family. So not far, but not close. 5 miles isn't that far away though, but they did go to his trailer and they were able to get a warrant and go inside this trailer and look around. They didn't find anything. However, I have to also add that Megan and this man, both of them have lawyered up and both of them are refusing a polygraph test. So say what you will about that. Some people are, you know, some people say that that's fine. You're protecting yourself, whatever, whether you're guilty or not, it's okay to refuse. Some people look at that as a sign of guilt. Whatever the case may be, this mystery man, this mystery drug man, as well as Megan, the girlfriend, have both lawyered up and are refusing to take a polygraph. And it's the whole totality of the circumstances and what's going on, I think, that makes me look at Megan a little bit strange is, you know, multiple things. You know, the fact that she failed to report him missing right away, the fact that her story keeps changing, the fact that she has lawyered up, the fact that she has refused to take a polygraph. So all those things are a concern. Now, I believe that mom, and I'll refer to her as mom throughout the reading, I believe that mom definitely believes that this other drug man has definitely something to do with her son's disappearance and possibly Megan, the girlfriend, knows more than what she's saying or what she's admitting. And so that's what we're going to focus the reading on today. Okay, so we're going to ask the cards kind of, you know, we want to know what happened to him. We don't know if he is, you know, passed away or alive. And, you know, definitely where he is, regardless of which one of those it is. Okay, where is he? And does Megan know more than what she's saying or admitting to? and this mystery man, I think I'll refer to him as mystery man throughout the reading. I don't want to keep saying drug person, but I'll just say mystery man because I don't know who this is. What is the involvement of mystery man, if any? Okay, so that's kind of what today's reading is going to focus on. I also want to mention, I'm going to be starting out, I have the Heaven and Earth Tarot, the New Era Elements, and my Universal Lo Scarabio. And in the Universal Lo Scarabio, I want to, in all of them, but especially the Universal Scarabio, I want to definitely tell you guys to watch out for the Seven of Cups and the Temperance card. So in this particular deck, the Temperance card is a woman standing at a cauldron and she's kind of mixing something. It looks like she's brewing something, okay? She's creating something. And that kind of, to me, I can associate that with sometimes drugs, okay? Basically creating something, making something, along those lines, anything along those lines. So also the Seven of Cups, that is a foggy mind, you're not thinking straight, and sometimes you are not thinking straight because of something that you're on, something that you're taking, okay? So definitely let's keep an eye out for both of those cards. All right, so first I want to just pull three or four cards just to see what comes up in Bradley Allen's case. All right, Bradley Allen, actually, I don't usually shuffle with reversals, but I do want to throw in some reversals today. All right, so Bradley Allen, what do we need to know about Bradley Allen? Bradley Wayne Allen. What do we need to know about Bradley Wayne Allen? Let me put his picture up here. All right, Bradley Wayne Allen. What about Bradley Wayne Allen? Let's see, what is this? Okay, reflection. And of course, the sun is like right in the way. Okay. So we've got a seven. Most importantly, though, we've got material possession. So, okay. That one kind of concerns me because that makes me feel like he was held someplace. Okay. All right, so I'm looking at that High Priestess, and that's the Divine Feminine. And so I know I'm just kind of asking a general kind of an opening for this case here, but I feel like this is possibility, or this is a possibility that this is Megan. This is a feminine card, okay? So I'm kind of at this point feeling like she's coming up in the reading. Okay, let's see what we got here. All right, we've got Mom. And then let me pull some up here. All right, we've got the Tower. So we've got whatever happened. This is him. This is Bradley. All right, so So right away, I feel like Mom is coming up and girlfriend Megan is coming up, okay? So these two people are, you know, definitely impactful in this case. And it's interesting that in this particular deck, the High Priestess kind of comes off as cold just because of the color, okay? Usually the High Priestess can be someone who's very sensitive, someone who's intuitive, someone who knows things that most people don't know. This is someone who just kind of, you know, can sometimes represent peacefulness, balance, but it can also represent a partnership, okay, because it is a two. So definitely this kind of makes me feel like this is heaven, or not heaven, why am I saying heaven? This is Megan, okay? So this can also be a person who is overly sensitive, easily hurt. So that might be some of her attributes. If anyone is familiar with Megan or knows her, those might be some of her personal traits that she has, okay? She can also be a peacemaker. So all those things kind of go with the High Priestess. But in this particular deck, like I said, is cold. I get that, not the warmth that you would think would accompany a High Priestess in, let's say, a normal traditional Rider-Waite deck, okay? So I get cold. I get icy, okay? So, and definitely involved in this case, and she may not even be that way, but I feel like in this case she has been cold and icy. So that is definitely coming out, whereas we have the exact opposite for Mom. Okay, so Mom is coming out completely different. If you look at these two cards, they're actually night and day. Okay, so we've got two women involved in his disappearance. We have one coming out looking cold and stoic, and we have another one coming out looking warm and caring and completely different and loving. Okay, so let's just keep that in mind. So not the best card, I think, to come out and describe her. With the Eight of Swords, I really do feel like it's a possibility that he was held against his will. Okay, so, and, you know, let's look at all of the symbolisms around, or the geographical symbols around. We have water, we have definitely outside, we have mountains, but most importantly, I'm thinking this is an exterior issue. He was held possibly outside, okay, and could possibly have been blindfolded as well. But the Fool here, okay, tells me that he did not see the danger or recognize the danger that he was in, okay? So he literally did not expect this to happen. This is usually someone starting out on their journey. They can be a bit naive, okay? They have high hopes, and they're not thinking of the consequences necessarily that could potentially, you know, come in their path. And so, you know, I do feel like this is also indicating, you know, let's go back to Megan's statement. Megan does say that she, or Megan claims that they got into an argument and he left. He walked away. Okay, he didn't drive, but he walked away. He walked through the woods, or he walked to the woods, or whatever, to cool down. And this Fool does look like he is walking. So I actually kind of do feel like, I think that this puts some credibility on her story in the fact that he did walk. Okay, I don't know why he walked, if it was truly because they got into an argument or if he was supposed to be meeting someone. I have no idea, but I do feel like there is some sort of credibility to the fact that he did go walking, because this guy, okay, the Fool, which represents us all, you know, we are all this character at one point in our life, many times over, but this Fool here is, to me, representing him walking. And this is what he comes into, okay? So this is devastating. This is something that just comes out of the blue. This actually kind of confirms this one here when I say that he didn't expect it. This here comes out of the blue. It's literally unexpected. You don't see it coming. It's usually something sudden, something abrupt, something that can't be stopped. It's literally going to happen whether you want it to or not. Most times it can be livable, though. Most times in our day-to-day life, we do have challenges and obstacles that come to us in our lives, and we overcome them. Sometimes they change us, right? But we learn from it, and we move on, and we rebuild, and we rebuild our foundation stronger. So this is what this card typically means. But you know, when you're reading on true crime, it's a completely different scenario, and this was devastating. Okay, so far right now, I'm not happy with The coldness of this person, the possibility that he could have been held, the fact that he was definitely not expecting whatever happened to him, and the fact that whatever happened to him is represented by the Tower card is not good. Okay, so this really means destruction. Okay, this is destruction. And these people coming out of this tower or this structure, they're probably not going to have a very good landing, right? So physical harm is what I'm taking from this particular card for this reading, okay? But that eye up there tells me that someone's seen it. Someone knows. Someone's seen it. And to me, usually this eye is the eye that's causing the destruction, okay? I'm actually going to take that as a little bit something different. I feel like there's actually someone else who has seen something. There's someone else besides the perpetrator that has seen something, okay? And that can also go with this one here. So is this that other eye? I don't know. We have to draw more cards to kind of figure that out. So we have also the Ace of Wands, which is the one which is like kind of a new thought. You know, I feel like, you know, wands are fire, and that is our inner self, spirituality, our goals, our passions, our desires, our wants. So I feel like this was actually Bradley. I think this is representing Bradley. And there was something, I kind of feel like this idea of him leaving at night was not due to an argument. I think that there was another reason. And whatever that reason is, it's this Ace of Wands. But I don't necessarily, I'm not seeing anything here about an argument per se, because I'm looking at this Fool. And he doesn't look upset. He doesn't look distressed. He just looks like he literally has no care in the world. Like he's just out on any other day of adventure, just another day. And I kind of feel like there wasn't, I don't know, or this could be the argument. But I don't feel like it was an argument that led him to walk away that night or to leave the house. And then we've got Reflection. So we've got the Seven of Pentacles. This is that not midway card. It's not a midway card. It's not a five. It's a little bit past that, but it's another stage in the game where you stop and you say, okay, you know, let's kind of collect our thoughts and see where we're at and see how we're going to go forward and see what we need to change from here. But what I notice about this card is that there's one good pentacle on the ground, okay? It looks like he's harvesting or he's going out to check his crops, and it doesn't look like there's much success, but there is hope, right? There's something there that he can work with. And this is a material possession. So this to me kind of does talk about Bradley's financial situation. In this interview with his mom does say that he made pretty good money doing what he was doing, but he couldn't handle his finances. He spent on things that he didn't need, okay? And that's probably pretty normal with, you know, a person that struggles with drugs. And I kind of feel like this is representing that struggle. This down here would be the drugs, okay? That was what he primarily probably focused on, and the rest of his responsibilities or the rest of his situation was probably in this condition. Okay, and he wasn't necessarily, I can't say that he was necessarily happy about it or upset about it. It just was what it was. Okay, but this right here tells me that the value in his life was probably, you know, money for those drugs. Okay, unfortunately. And that, like I said, that's, you know, typically what happens when you have addiction or deal with addiction. But we've also got this here, the Two of Wands, and that kind of goes right with this Ace. So we've got an idea, and then now we're kind of trying to figure out how we're going to go forward. There's something, I want to leave these two cards out because these two cards are really, really important, because I want to know what this Ace of Wands represents. again, wands are, you know, spiritual, passion, driven. These cards are representing someone who is driven. They've got something that they want to do, what they want to achieve, and they are determined to do it. And this is the beginning of that. So what was this beginning that he wanted to do? Okay. Was he starting to reflect on his finances? Was he wanting to possibly kind of change this situation? Did he want out of this? Did he not want anything to do with this anymore? I don't know, but I kind of want to leave these two cards out, and actually I want to leave the Fool and I want to leave the Tower out as well, and see what else we have. So I want to ask specifically about Megan, the girlfriend, and what happened that early morning on July 18th to make Bradley walk out of that house or leave. If he even left. I want to just ask what happened at Bradley and Megan's trailer that morning on July 18th. What happened? Let's see if we can find out if there was an argument. Okay, so we've got an Emperor. So to me, this is not Bradley. We've got the Hierophant. We've got a work card. We've got a lot of other players. Okay. So, right off the bat, the two of cups is coming out reversed. So I do think that this is representing some problems in the relationship. So there were some things going on between Bradley and Megan that weren't that good. So the relationship was struggling prior to this. Okay, so that's important. Now, I do feel like the Emperor and the King of Pentacles are different players, because this is not the age range in which I would put Bradley in. Okay, this is like the top of the top. This is like the boss. Okay, the person in charge. This is authority. This is someone that he would go to, someone that he would work for, someone that, you know, this is someone above him, as well as this person as well. And this is money. So with these two cards here, I'm kind of concerned, because I feel like, is there something that he did that caused a loss of money for this person? Is this a loss of money for whoever this is here? Because this here is not Bradley. Okay, that's not Bradley. And I feel like it's related to this. So I get that the relationship was not good. Okay, there were some struggles, and I feel like it's a possibility that he could have possibly lost some money that was supposed to go to whoever this was. And he was worried about it. This Nine of Swords, okay, that's a no sleep card. So he was bothered about it. I don't know if he was concerned about losing his life per se, but I do think that he was concerned about it, and there were other things that he was concerned about as well. This is a nine, okay? There's several swords up there. There's several things bothering this person. It's not just one, okay? So this tells me that that really does kind of make sense with that Seven of Pentacles, because that shows reflection. So I do think that he was at a point in his life, and 37 is kind of getting to that, you know, you're getting a little bit older. You're starting to mature and grow and, you know, evolve and learn things. And so he could have been getting to a point in his life where he was tired. Where did that card go? He was tired. Okay. He was not liking this anymore. And now that I'm looking at it, I kind of feel like this Ace of Wands was him starting to look at his future in a different way. I kind of feel like he was actually at a point in time where he didn't want to be on drugs anymore. I really actually feel that way. I don't think that he wanted that kind of life for him and his child anymore. I think he wanted to change. And he was at that crossroads in his life of trying to actually make a change. And I think that that could possibly have been causing problems in the relationship, because from what I understand, Megan as well had some drug issues. And so this could have concerned her, because we know that when someone wants to stop doing drugs or stop any addiction, they have to want to do that themselves, okay? You can scream all day long and ask them to stop and beg them to stop, but unless they want to do that themselves, it's going to be very challenging for that person to be successful. And sometimes in order to make that change, okay, or to want to do that, one has to hit rock bottom in order to kind of say, okay, this is enough, I'm tired of this. So I do feel like he was at that level, and that had struck something in him. That had struck something in him to change, okay? And I do think that he was in the midst of that change. But it makes me wonder if, because of that, that was going to create some problems with possibly someone else in the drug area, okay? Was it going to cause a loss of money or finances? Were they scared of him not producing or not purchasing or something along those lines? Or were they scared that he would report things that he knew? I don't know, but that's kind of what I'm thinking, okay? And I do think that he was definitely, this is a work card. This is an eight, okay? It's an eight, it's a work card. This is taking one step at a time, and I feel like this really actually goes well with, honestly, I kind of feel like he was starting to try to get sober. I really do. I really do. I get that feeling that he was trying to work on himself. This is a working card. This is taking it one step at a time, and in his situation, that is exactly what he has to do, take it one step at a time, and I think he was about to embark on that, okay? He had tried many times before. In the interview, his mom does say that he was in and out of several rehab centers. It never worked. So this does kind of make sense with that. It was something that was ongoing. He had struggled with it before, but he was tackling it again. Okay, I really do think that is going, that's what's happening. And then we have the Hierophant. So this here is often associated with religion, but it can also represent change. Okay, it is a five, and sometimes even myself, when I pull this card, I neglect that it's a five. And fives in tarot are kind of chaos, and so I feel like this card does represent change, because fives can sometimes represent change and other things as well. But this is... In this case, I think it represents hierarchy. That's what I think it represents in this case. It represents hierarchy in a system, in a world, okay? In a world of drugs, in that world. I don't think it necessarily represents religion per se. Like I said, it can be society, system, societal norms, anything like that. And I kind of feel like there's a drug world that Bradley was unfortunately a part of, and it did have a hierarchy system, okay? There were people in charge, okay? There were bosses, and there were bosses of bosses, and there was money to be made, okay? Money to be made in this world, okay? These two, if it's two people or if it's one, this is the person probably making the money, okay? And I do believe that there was something going on in Bradley's life where this making money was at risk. And that could potentially have cost him his life. The Four of Pentacles, again, we've got money, we've got finances. you know, I'm looking at this card, and I love this Four of Pentacles. It's like one of my favorite cards in the deck. This Four of Pentacles makes me feel like, you know, Four of Pentacles can sometimes be frugality. It can be, you know, you need to save, or sometimes it can just be possessions, right? Because it's, we always tend to put it in terms of money, and I do think it is money, but, you know, it's possessions, okay? It's whatever kind of material possession that you're holding on to. And I do feel like this person here is holding on to something, and he's outgrown it, right? He doesn't even fit in that house anymore. He looks silly there. He's outgrown it. He needs to move on. He needs to move up and move on, because this isn't working. So I do feel like it is someone holding on to something that's no longer serving them. And again, that's why I feel like Bradley was on the verge of changing. He was on the verge of a transition, because I do feel like he had outgrown this world. Okay, he was changing. He was changing and he was evolving, and I don't think that he wanted to be a part of that anymore. I really don't. I think that he had held on it for so long, but was getting tired of it. Okay, so I do kind of feel like that is a sign that he was changing. And for his stability, its foundation, that was what he was used to. That was his life for a long time. You know, it becomes a habit, right? You get used to living your life a certain way. And so I think that, you know, that makes the change all the more difficult. Besides the addiction, trying to break the addiction in and of itself. It's hard when you're addicted to something like that. You know, it's not easy to just say, hey, I'm going to get up tomorrow and not do drugs. You know, it just doesn't work that way. You know, so this is a hard card to overcome, but I think he was on the verge of trying to overcome it. And then the Queen of Chalices, which I do not believe is Megan in this case, because this is an older person. There is someone else coming to the forefront as being a caring supporter. So I don't feel like it's his mother. I feel like it's someone else that he had in his life that was offering support and just a shoulder to, you know, there might have been someone else. And I really don't feel like it's mom. I feel like mom came out as the Empress, and this is someone else. This is someone else in his life that was offering support, or could or would be able to shed some light on whether or not any of this is true. Okay, so this was somebody that he was going to, I think, unbeknownst to Megan, unbeknownst to his girlfriend, that he was talking to, and he was expressing his, you know, feelings and his new desires to change. Okay, so I kind of feel like that's where we're headed. We're headed to definitely something going on with the drugs and something with that. So I want to ask again, just yes or no, was Megan involved in this case? Was Megan involved with the disappearance? Was Megan involved with the disappearance? Yes or no? Was Megan involved with the disappearance? All right, so we've got the Six of Wands, okay, but we've got it reversed. So the Six of Wands, actually, to me, is it's an ego card, okay? It can represent hero, but I look at it as an ego card, but more importantly, I look at it as the focus. The focus, the attention is on that person. The attention is focused on that one person, right? So when it comes out reversed, I look at it as the attention is not on the right person, okay? The attention is not on the right person. So this actually makes me feel like Megan doesn't necessarily have anything to do with it. That doesn't mean she doesn't know what's going on or doesn't suspect what's going on, but this to me, again, if you read it like that, the attention is on this person. The attention is on one person. Now the attention is not on that person. The attention is not on that person. The attention is not on the right person. Okay, so that kind of leads me to believe that although Megan doesn't look like the nicest or the kindest or the most honest, or the most upstanding person, this kind of makes me feel like we're looking at someone else, okay? Does Megan know who the someone else? Does Megan know who the person is? Yes or no? Does Megan know who the person is? Does Megan know who the person is? Okay, so we've got a juggling card. Okay, the two of pentacles reverse. So this is a juggling card, trying to make things work, trying to figure out how to balance things out. Okay, so now we've got reverse, not being able to balance things out, not being able to work things out. Okay, it's two things. So it's sometimes twos can represent partnership, duality, a decision making type of thing. Usually, again, two. Okay, if you go back to it, remember we talked about the high priestess. I think, did I pull the high priestess where I said it was cold? Yes. Okay. Remember, usually the high priestess is a feminine. It represents the divine feminine. So this is also a two. It also represents the divine feminine. Okay, so this is definitely a kind of a female card. What did we say about this one? This has strong intuition. Strong intuition. Yes. Okay, I think she does. I think she does suspect. I think she knows. I think this kind of tells me that she doesn't necessarily know what happened, but she does have an idea and she does suspect. Okay, so interesting. I don't think she's the one who did it. I don't think that she's the one physically behind it, but she does kind of have an idea, and she has her suspicions. Okay, she has her suspicions. Is it this mystery man? Is it the mystery man? Does the mystery man have anything to do with Bradley's disappearance? Does the mystery man have anything to do with Bradley's disappearance? Yes or no? Does the mystery man have anything to do with Bradley's disappearance? Okay. So we've got the five of swords. And this one also came out reversed. So the five of swords is usually that I'll win at no cost, no matter who I take down, no matter what I do to get there, I'm going to win. But I look at this particular card as a little bit different, because I kind of look at it as a betrayal by several people. Okay, so whoever this person is in the middle, at least that's how they feel. That's how they are. That's how they feel about the situation. It doesn't mean that that's the reality of the situation. It just means that that's how they feel about it. So they feel betrayed by several people. So it comes out reversed. Okay. So again, with reversals, it doesn't always necessarily mean the opposite of or anything like that. I just kind of feel like in this case, as far as my question is concerned, is Mystery Man involved in this situation? To me, what it's kind of showing me is that I think yes, but not the only one. Okay, I mean, I'm kind of looking at those people that are his betrayers, and I feel like we're really kind of looking at a group of possible people that are involved in Bradley's disappearance. So I do kind of feel like I'm gonna have to pull another clarifier on this one. Because this is typically a no card, but I feel like it's coming out to me as a no, because he's not the only one. I do think that there's other people involved, so I need to pull another card here really quick on this. Is Mystery Man involved in the disappearance, or is he even responsible for the disappearance of Bradley? Mystery Man. Okay, so we've got the World. Okay, so I do feel like Mystery Man is a concern. Okay, Mystery Man's a concern. So this is endings. Well, I mean, I hate to say endings, because there's no endings in tarot. There's only I don't want to say, what's a good word, maybe a conclusion, or there's really no endings, it's just new beginnings, right? It's an ongoing cycle, okay? And this is a cycle. So this is kind of like completion, okay? That's the word I'm looking for, completion of a cycle. And then once a cycle is completed, you go on to another one. But this is the World card, and I do feel like this has so many, this speaks volumes to me about this mystery man, okay? It just kind of definitely says that there was an ending. And like I said, I hate using the term ending in tarot. But in this particular case, because we do have a person missing, I do think that it's very, very literal, okay? I think that there was an ending. There's an ending here for several things, for several people. There was an ending for Bradley, I think, unfortunately. There's an ending for this person as well, okay? Because his life has changed, regardless of whether or not he's in jail right now. His life has changed as well because he has done something that he can never return from. The family's life has changed, okay? Even Megan's life has changed. The son's life has changed. There's so many things that have been affected, so many lives that have been affected by this, okay? And not in a good way, because it came out reverse. So not in a good way. This is usually, you can look at this as a very, very good card, okay? It's like you've completed something. Now you're on to the next phase in your journey, right? But when it comes out reversed, it's like you completed something, but it wasn't the ending that you really wanted. It wasn't a full 100% good completion, okay? Or maybe it was something that you completed, but you didn't do a very good job, or you didn't learn anything from it. You didn't take anything from it. So I do kind of feel like, unfortunately, this is also a card that's kind of indicating to me that it's possible that Bradley is no longer alive, okay? And again, I don't know that for a fact, but you know, with that card coming out, it does make me feel that way, in my opinion. All right, so let me go ahead and switch decks. I want to pull a couple of cards with the Heaven and Earth tarot deck. And again, actually, let me go ahead and I do want to add some reversals here. Now I want to get into asking questions about where Bradley is. Where can Bradley be located? God, it looks like it's going to rain here. It got super dark all of a sudden. Where is Bradley Wayne Allen? Where is Bradley Wayne Allen? So far, I do kind of feel like Bradley did leave to take a walk. That story might actually have some substance to it because of that Fool card. But I think that him going missing has something to do with something else entirely. And I think that the girlfriend, Megan, does have some suspicions and possibly some information that she could share that she's not sharing. I don't necessarily, by the looks of the cards, think that she has anything to do with it, but definitely this mystery man, I think, has a bigger hand in what's going on, and I think it's something to do more with drugs, and I think it's something to do with finances involving drugs. And I kind of am so far getting the impression that it's possible that Bradley was looking to make a change in his life. And someone didn't want that to happen. So where is Bradley now? Where is Bradley now? Okay. And we've got another, the Hierophant again. Wow, okay. All right, and then we've got Princess of Cups, so the Page. Okay, so And the Two of Wands. So, yeah, I do think that he went out that night. I do think that he left. I think that that part of the story is true. He left. He walked away. And it could have been to calm down or to cool off or whatever the case may be. But I do feel like this is also another indication at night he did leave, or early hours in the morning he did leave. Okay, he left. But you know, with the Justice card coming out, this gives me a good feeling. We are very early on in this case, okay? It happened in 2017, and I know that the police did get a late start, and it doesn't sound like they've been doing the best of best jobs, but this gives me hope that this case is eventually going to be put to rest, that there is going to be some justice in this case. Okay, so this is a good card, and I do suspect that they will have an arrest with this card. I would venture to say within this year. Okay, within a year, I think that they are going to have some more information and an arrest in this case, and there'll be justice in this case. We've got the Hierophant again. I think that that really does, right next to the Justice coming out, is amazing to me. I feel like this Hierophant, again, is someone to do in the world of drugs as far as hierarchy. This is someone high up on the totem pole. The fact that it's coming out right next to the Justice makes me feel like it's a possibility that this person's going down. They might actually, and by they I mean the investigators, might actually be taking time on this case, because whoever this mystery man is, and again, I don't know who this is or what their level is or their position is in that world, but the investigators might actually be using this to kind of, you know, take down someone of importance, okay, someone high up in that world. And so I feel like that could be potentially what they're working on. This is someone who has control of others, who has other people working for them, who has followers, okay, people who are even scared of this person. But I do think that whoever this person is, and I'm not even sure if it's Mystery Man or if it's Mystery Man's boss. It could be Mystery Man's boss for all I know. But I do feel like this person here, the fact, like I said, that it came out right next to the Justice card tells me that there is going to be some justice in this case, and somebody's going down for it. And I think that that is the person that is responsible for what happened to Bradley. But this reading is about, where is Bradley? That's where I asked, okay? Or that was the question that I asked. And I'm looking at these cards here, and I'm looking at this one, I'm looking at this one, I'm looking at this one, and well, not so much this one, but I've got two cards here that have water in them, a body of water. Okay, so we've got actually two cups. Okay, is this a cup here? No, this is a pentacle, but we've got a cups here. So we've got cups, we've got water. Okay, so I'm actually going to include this page as well. So we've got three cups with a body of water in them. So because I'm asking about, you know, where could Bradley be located, this kind of makes me feel like it's a possibility that there could potentially be a body of water where he could be located. You know, so I don't know that area. I don't know Fountain Hill, Arkansas, if there's any, you know, bodies of water in that area, but I do feel like that is a location that they should look, because I do feel like he is outside. All of these cards are someone outside, and granted, most cards, tarot cards, are with someone outside, but this is very specific. It's outside, and it's either in water or near water. Okay, surrounding water or in a watery area, I think that should be, you know, that could potentially be where he's at. And this here, you know, the five, again, we've had quite a few fives come up. We've had quite a few fives. We've had the Hierophant twice. We've had the Five of Swords. And now we have the Five of Cups. This is kind of like, this can be seen at its seriousness as depression, okay? you know, so we've got someone in this case that is not doing well, and I'm kind of torn between. I honestly feel like it's Bradley, to be honest with you. I really do. And because usually when I look at this card, I look at shame. I feel the word that comes to mind is shame. And I kind of feel like he is definitely coming through, and I feel like he has some shame as far as the way his life was, but I actually think that he was in the process of trying to change it, and he was interrupted with that. He you know, I think with those wands, that Ace of Wands and the Two of Wands, and we've got the Two of Wands here as well, I feel like he was in the process of change. He was going to make a decision, I think, to turn his life around. And that is when this happened. And I think that has a little bit to do with why it happened as well. But I do think that there is some shame on his part, for, you know, how his life was. But I think the important thing that, you know, I can even say to him is that it wasn't all bad, okay? There were good aspects as well. So don't focus on the negative. Focus on the good, okay? He did have a son. He had people who loved him. He seemed to be a very, very kind man, very smart, very intelligent. You know, so those are the things that fill up these cups, okay? So that's what I would tell Bradley right now. Don't necessarily focus on this. Focus on this. Focus more on this, okay? And then we have the Nine of Wands, which, again, just tells me the battles that he went through. And this is another card that makes me feel like he was on the verge of change. He was on the verge of something different, because a nine is, again, in tarot with numerology, it's usually 0 through 10, or 1 through 10, rather, the aces being 1. And that is a completion of a cycle, okay? We go through many completions of cycles daily, and we go through several large ones in our life. And I do believe that these wands here in the back were all the times that his mom talked about how he went into rehab and how he would, you know, mess up again, or then he'd go back into rehab. These were trials and tribulations that he had went through in his life. But this one right here that this guy is holding, this to me was the one that he was getting ready to embark upon. He was actually, I think, going to try to get off drugs, try to get out of this world, change his life around. I think he was growing. I think he was evolving. I think he was changing, okay? Changing spiritually, changing, just he was getting older. And I think that he was tired. He was tired of this. This is a person that's very tired, and they've got a bandage on their head, so they can, you know, they kind of look like they've been through the ringer. And I think that that was how he felt. He had had enough. He had had enough, and he was seeking fulfillment through other means at this point in his life. Okay, so I take this card as, yes, he did walk away that night and take a walk, but I also feel like this does symbolize something bigger, and that he was seeking fulfillment for something that he was lacking in his life, and he, I think, knew that in order to fulfill that, he needed to let something go. He needed to let something go, and that was the drugs. So I do think that he was on the verge of changing, and that possibly pissed someone off. So let me go ahead and draw a couple of cards with the New Era elements, and I do kind of feel, though, at this point, I'm probably going to shut this video off here pretty soon, because I'm really trying to keep my videos within an hour in length. But I do feel like we got a lot of information. I do feel like the girlfriend, again, I'm going to recap one more time. You know, Megan probably has some idea as to what happened. I don't think she did anything herself. But I do think that this mystery man definitely has some involvement. I don't feel in my heart that Bradley is alive at this point. And I do think something was done to him, and I think that it's potentially possible that he is outside, okay, near a body of water. but definitely outside, I think. And I do think that he was in the process of a big change in his life. I think that he was going to try to change the way he was living his life and get off drugs. And I'm thinking that it's possible that that really had someone scared. And that could be the reasoning or the motive behind whatever happened to him. So just a couple of cards to kind of end this reading, and then we'll see what comes out here. Okay, yeah, so the moon. So that does tell me that there's going to be more things come to light. So we've got, again, so we've got the, we've got another five. We've got the, what is that? That's the, earth. Or, no, sorry, fire. So we've got the, five of wands, okay? The four of, I can never remember these symbols. What is this one? Swords. So the four of swords, remember, this is usually the guy, or it looks like a soldier that's laying, it kind of looks like a coffin, but he's laying there, and he has three swords up on the wall behind him, and I think one is down below him to his side. So that is typically what this card is. And then I'll pull one more. And to be honest with you, okay, we've got another four. Let me just pull one more. Nice one to end on. Sometimes when I'm reading in these types of cases, that four of swords can represent death to me, okay? Not always. It can just simply be a rest, okay? It can be a rest. It can be that someone's tired and they need to get more sleep. It can be a whole host of things, okay? But in these particular types of readings, I sometimes do look at that particular card as death. So in this case, I feel like that's a possibility that we are talking about the fact that Bradley is no longer here on Earth. Okay, and then we've got what is this picture? There's a whole lot of these birds here coming together. Sticking with one another, protecting each other. Yeah, so this kind of also makes me feel like this one here tells me that there's more information going to come out. Okay, they are going to have more information. I think it's just bits and pieces. I don't think that they'll ever get the full story. I'm not sure if they'll get the full story, but I do think that there's going to be more bits and pieces come out. Okay, the moon is illumination, but it doesn't illuminate 100%. It does bring some light to a situation, and I think that that's going to be enough information for them to go forward with something legally, okay? I think it's going to bring some hope, okay? I think that they're going to come across I honestly, when I look at all these birds or ducks or whatever they are, okay, there's like hundreds of them, okay? They're all kind of sticking together. I feel like this is actually going to be a drug bust. I really do. I really feel like there's going to be a whole bunch of people that they take down. I think that they're kind of trying to do that with this case. I think that they're trying to work quietly, and they're using this as a case, or they're using this, I think, as an opportunity to take down the whole lot of them. I really do. That's how I'm looking at this card. And it is a truce. It's like a giving up, and I think that they will. It'll just be, I think it'll be a dismantling of a system, okay? And that kind of goes with that Hierophant card as well. Okay, so the Five of Wands, this is like a battle, okay? Look at that airplane dropping bombs or missiles or whatever it is. This is like confrontation, a battle, conflict. So this is like a war. Okay, this is definitely like a war between this system of people and the local law enforcement. And with this victory here, to me, this actually tells me that there is going to be victory in this case, and that does go with that justice card. Okay, so I do think that everything is going to be okay. It's not going to be okay because obviously someone has lost their life. Two daughters, I think, have lost their father. A son has lost their father. A mother has lost her son. So it's not going to be okay, but I do think that this case is going to have some conclusion to it. There is going to be answers, I think, involved in this case, okay? And then we have comfort. So we have four, and I do feel like that is another sign that there is going to be some comfort given to the families, okay, or to Bradley's family, I should say. Okay, and then the daughter of water, which is the Page of Cups. So who is this? The Page of Cups. I kind of feel like this is someone that's going to play an important role in this case, and it could be someone that is going to help bring this case to a close, possibly someone who has information. This is someone younger, okay, or it doesn't necessarily have to be someone younger. It can be it can be something that's in its early stages of something. It could be a relationship, but I do feel like we're talking about a younger individual possibly that is going to shed some light on this on this case. All right, so it's kind of up there with the moon card. So whoever this is, I do, and this actually kind of could be Megan as well. Is it possible that Megan is going to finally open up and share some information that she has? That's where I'm kind of actually leaning to. So I kind of wonder if eventually, because I don't think she has anything to do with it per se, but I think that she does suspect, and I think she might actually be scared to say anything, but I think when it comes down to when it comes down to it, I think she might actually have some information that is going to shed some light on it. Okay, so anyway, that is this week's reading, and that again was on Bradley Wayne Allen, and I have high hopes for this case. I really do. I have high hope. I think that this case is going to be solved within a year. I'm really going to actually keep updating or checking up on this case because, like I said, it's so fresh, it's new, and I really seen some cards in here that make me feel like there are going to be some answers, that his mom can have some answers. And, I pray for his mom and his family, and I send out good vibrations to them. And I hope that there is some conclusion for them so that they can try to, continue to live their lives as best as they can. And, all right, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next week.